May peace be on all of you. Myself, Dr. Majid Khan, Associate Professor, Loknetre Dr. J.D. Pawar College of Pharmacy, Kalwan, Nasik. I welcome all of you in this fourth lecture of antibiotic. In this video, that is in lecture 4, we will cover cephalosporins, which is one type of beta-lactam antibiotic. Learning outcome: after completion of this topic, a student able to understand the chemistry of cephalosporins, remember the classification of cephalosporin with example, understand the structural activity relationship of cephalosporins, and understand the chemical degradation of cephalosporin and beta-lactamase resistance of cephalosporin. So, cephalosporin, so it is also beta-lactam antibiotic isolated from cephalosporium species or prepared semi-synthetically. Abraham and Newton, scientist name, in Oxford, isolates three principal antibiotic component. First one is cephalosporin P1 with minimum antibacterial activity. Second component is cephalosporin N, means this one, cephalosporin N, also called as penicillin N. And third one is cephalosporin C. Cephalosporin C, this one is a cephalosporin C. So this scientist Abraham and Newton isolate three components from this bacteria or microorganism. First one is cephalosporin P1, which having very minimum antibacterial activity. Second component is cephalosporin N, also called as penicillin N. And third one is cephalosporin C. This one is cephalosporin C. The structure of penicillin N was discovered to be 4-amino, 4-carboxybutyl penicillinic acid. So, I affect name of this penicillin N is 4-amino, 4-carboxybutyl penicillinic acid. So, as we discussed previously regarding penicillinic acid, so penicillinic acid, that is, it contains this part, it is called as penicillinic acid, that is penum with dimethyl group and carboxylic group. And there is a side chain, so this side chain is 4-amino, 4-carboxybutyl, and basic is penicillinic acid. The amino acid side chain confer more activity against gram-negative bacteria, but less activity against gram-positive organism. Then cephalosporin C, this one, cephalosporin C is a close congener of penicillin N containing dihydrothiazine ring instead of thiazolidine ring of penicillin. So this ring, it is called as dihydrothiazine, but in case of this penicillin N, it is a thiazolidine ring. So this cephalosporin C is also congener of penicillin N, but the difference is it contains 6-member ring dihydrothiazine, but here penicillin N contains thiazolidine ring. The discovery that alpha amino side chain could be removed to efficiently produce 7-amino cephalosporonic acid. So when we remove this side chain, that is side chain, then we get the 7-ACA, that is 7-amino cephalosporonic acid. Same as in case of penicillin, if we remove the side chain from the penicillin, we get 6-APA, amino penicillinic acid. So similarly here, if we remove the side chain from the cephalosporine here, then it is called as ACA, 7-amino cephalosporonic acid. The commercially available drugs are obtained from this 7-ACA as a semi-synthetic product. So this 7-ACA without side chain, it is used commercially to prepare the other semi-synthetic derivative. Then nomenclature of cephalosporine. The fused ring system is designated by USP nomenclature as 5-thia-1-aza-bicyclooctuene. So it is a general structure of cephalosporine. So according to USP, so here according to USP, nitrogen given the number 1, then this one is 2, this 3 and 4, and then sulfur is 5. On fifth position there is a sulfur. So according to USP, this general structure of cephalosporine, the name is given 5-thia-1-aza. On fifth position sulfur, on one position aza. Bicyclo means two cycle, octuene. So here there are total 8 carbon. If we start from nitrogen 1, then 2, 3, 4, sulfur is 5, then this 6, 7 and this 8. So total 8 carbon, that is oct. On second position there is a double bond, therefore ene, that is alkene, 2-ene. So general name according to USP, 5-thia-1-aza-bicyclooctuene. In this system, cephalothene, so this is a natural cephalosporine, so it is a cephalothene. So according to this system, cephalothene is given the alpec name. 3-acetyl-oxymethyl, so it is a 3 position. This one is nitrogen is 1 position, 2, and this one is 3. So on third position, this side chain is attached, that is acetyl-oxymethyl. So it is an acetyl group with oxygen, and this CH2 is methyl. Acetyl-oxymethyl. Then on seventh position, this side chain is attached. 7-2-thionyl, it is a thionyl. Acetyl amino, so it is again acetyl group with amino, acetyl amino. 8-oxo means this oxo. 8-oxo, again 5-thia-1-aza-bicyclooctuene, 2 carboxylic acid. So here carboxylic acid present on its second position. So this cephalothene, which is a natural cephalosporine, the name is given, IUPAC name is given, 3-acetyl-oxymethyl, 7-2-thionyl, acetyl amino, 8-oxo, 5-thia-1-aza-bicyclooctuene, 2 carboxylic acid. A simplification that retains some of the systematic nature of chemical abstract procedure names the saturated bicyclic ring system with the lactam carbonyl oxygen CFOM. So here there is a structure of CFOM. So in penicillin there is a penum. Penum means 4 member ring, that is beta lactam ring with thiazolidine ring with carbonyl group. So here again there is a beta lactam ring with carbonyl group, and this one is a thiazine saturated. So here it is called as CFOM. According to this system, all commercially available cephalosporine and cephamycin are named 3-cepheme. 3-cepheme. Cepheme means here there is a E, means alkene. So this one is a saturated, therefore it is called as cepham, P-H-A-M, cepham. But in case of cephalosporine, maximum drug contain double bond on this position. Therefore, it is called as cepheme, that is alkene, C-E-P-H-E-M-S, cepheme, to designate the position of double bond. So, all derivative of cephalosporine is called as cepheme. So, it is about the, and then again, there is a, another name is given, cephalosporinic acid, as in case of penicillin, penicillinic acid is there. So, here without side chain, on this position, this structure is called as cephalosporonic acid. So it is about the nomenclature of cephalosporin. Then classification of cephalosporin. So here there is a two type of classification. First one according to generation or according to their discovery. So here there are fifth generation, means first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth and fifth generation. So in this table, the drug is given along with the generation. So here first generation example is cefazolin, cefalothin. Then second generation, cefotilan, cefoxitin, ciferoxime. Then third generation, cefotaxime, ceftazolidine, ceftizoxime, ceftriaxone, cefoperazone. Then fourth generation, cefepime, cefpirome. Fifth generation, ceftaroline, ceftobiprole. So it is according to generation. Similarly, according to route of administration, in this table is also given. That is according to route of administration. So oral cephalosporin, example cefadroxil, cefaclor, cefalexin. Parenteral cephalosporin, cefalothin, cefazolin, cefamendol. So here also given parenteral agent and oral agent. So there are two types of classification depending upon the generation and depending upon the route of administration. Now the important one is SAR, structural activity relationship. So here general structure is given of cephalosporin. Here is the side chain. So here first point of SAR, all known active cephalosporin and cefamycin are two cepheme. So here on second position there is a double bond, therefore cepheme, that is alkene. Three cepheme are inactive. It means if we shift this double bond from second position to third position, then it is called as three cepheme, but these drugs are inactive. So in short, two cepheme are active drug and three cepheme are inactive drug. Second point, absence of leaving group at third position provide high acid stability. So it is a third position. So here generally a leaving group is present. In maximum case, leaving group is present on third position. But if here there is a absence of this leaving group on third position, then it gives the high acid stability. Next point, introduction of polar substituent in amino acyl moiety side chain of cephalosporin confer the stability to some beta lactamase enzyme. So this point is same as in case of penicillin. That is introduction of polar substituent on this amino side chain. So introduction of polar substituent in amino acyl moiety side chain of cephalosporin, it confer the stability to some beta lactamase enzyme. For example, cefamendol. For example, here cefamendol, cefonicide, cefurinicide. So here there is a R1 and this one is R2, which is a leaving group. So here depending upon the R1 and R2. So here the example is cefamendol. Here the R1 equal to this structure, R2 equal to this structure. Cefonicide. So here R1 equal to this, R2 equal to this structure. Cefurinide, R1 and this one is R2. So these drug contain the polar group on the amino side chain. Therefore, it shows maximum activity against beta lactamase enzyme. Next point, steric factor as in cefaparazone that contain 4-ethyl-2,3-dioxo. 1 piperazinyl carbonyl group is resistance to beta lactamase enzyme. So it is the R1 and this one is R2. Drug name is cefaparazone. So here R1 equal to this structure, that is 4-ethyl, means this 4-ethyl, 2,3-dioxo, this 2,3-dioxo, 1 piperazine, this one is piperazinyl, this one is carbonyl group. So it is a side chain. On this side chain, this bulky group is attached. Therefore, there is a bulkiness on side chain. Therefore, this drug show the resistance against the beta lactamase enzyme. So point is same. If we increase the bulk on the side chain, there is an increase in activity against the beta lactamase enzyme. So here cefaparazone is an example which contain R1 equal to this, R2 equal to this living group. So here there is a big structure, that is 4-ethyl-2,3-dioxo-1-piperazinyl carbonyl group. Therefore, it shows resistance to beta-lactamase enzyme. Next point, alkoxy immunofunction. Alkoxy means alkyl group with oxygen. Immuno means when nitrogen attached to double bond. Alkoxy immunofunction in amino acyl group and methoxy group at 7th position of safim nucleus also show resistance against beta-lactamase bacteria. So again, regarding side chain, if we increase the bulkiness on the side chain, then the activity against beta-lactamase enzyme is increases. For example, cefotoxime. So here there is a alkoxy immuno. So here alkoxy means OCS3, that is methoxy. CH3O, or generally called as alkoxy immuno, C double bond N. This one is C double bond N. So alkoxy immuno function, same thing here. There is a alkoxy, that is methoxy, and immuno. Ceftazoxime is a drug. So here alkoxy immuno function in amino acyl group and methoxy group. So here is a methoxy group on 7th position. So it is a 7th position. Methoxy group is present, therefore these drugs show resistance against beta-lactamase bacteria. Next point, esterification of two carboxylic group give acid stable lipophilic ester that undergo hydrolysis in plasma. For example, ciferoxime acetyl and cefpodoxime proxetyl. These two drugs are very famous and available in market in number of under the number of trade name, mainly for children. So ciferoxime acetyl, cefpodoxime proxetyl are the beta lactamase resistant orally active ester prodrug derivative. So as we know, in general structure of cephalosporin, on second position there is a carboxylic group is present. So if you convert this carboxylic group into ester, then it produces the prodrug. So as we know, prodrug after entry into the body, after hydrolysis, it is again converted into parent compound. So here it is the first drug, ciferoxime acetyl. So here is a acidic group COOH, but here hydrogen is removed and this structure is attached. This structure is called as 1-hydroxyethyl acetate. So here COOH, from this COOH hydrogen is removed and this structure, that is 1-hydroxyethyl acetate, is attached to make the ester, that is called as ciferoxime acetyl. Here also, in case of cefodoxime, it is a structure of cefodoxime. So here is an acidic group, but here hydrogen of acidic group is removed by or replaced by 1-hydroxyethyl isopropyl carbonate. So this structure is called as 1-hydroxyethyl isopropyl carbonate. So it is also ester. So both these drugs are ester. After administration into the body, it is again converted into acidic form here and here, means it is converted into their parent structure. So esterification of two carboxylic acid give acid stable lipophilic ester. So purpose of esterification, that is to stabilize the drug in presence of acid in stomach. So prodrug, the function of ester formation to protect the drug from hydrolysis by the stomach acidic condition. So it is about the esterification. Next point, beta lactamase resistance is also enhanced if oximino substituent also feature polar function, as in ceftazidine, which has 2-methylpropionic acid on oximino group. Both steric and electronic property of alkoximino group may be contribute to resistance. So in previous point, that is the alkoximino function. So here again there is a immuno function, nitrogen connected to double bond, and alkoxy. So here combined feature, that is oxymino function, is also present and polar group is also present. So the name of drug is ceftazidine, which having the 2-methyl propionic acid. This one is 2-methyl propionic acid on oxymino function. So here oxymino function with bulkiness, therefore both these feature increase the activity against, or it increase the resistance against the beta lactamase enzyme. Then next point, that is the oral activity is conferred by phenylglycine substituent is attributed to increase acid stability of lactam ring, also important for high acid stability and therefore good oral activity. Or cephalosporin, when there is absence of leaving group at third position, but despite the presence of phenylglycine side chain in cephalosporin, phenylglycine is poorly absorbed orally because of solvolysis of 3-acetyl-oxy group in low pH of stomach. So here regarding this drug, it is a cephaloglycine. So as name indicate, side chain contain glycine. So this presence of this glycine on side chain, there is a increase the acid stability. It means in presence of acid or in stomach, it is stabilized. But here there is a leaving group on this third position. So here acetyl oxy leaving group, which is interfere the instability or which responsible for instability. So due to presence of this glycine, this drug may be orally active, but due to presence of this side chain, this group on third position, it is poorly absorbed. Why it is poorly absorbed? Because this group undergo solvolysis process or form the lactone ring. How it is formed? So here this carboxylic group, that is COOH, so here the lone pair of this oxygen attack, here there is a removal of water molecule hydrogen and this OH is removed, so it form the this type of ring called as lactone, and this product is called as desacetyl cephalosporin lactone, or the reaction is called as solvolysis. So the resulting 3-hydroxy derivative undergo lactonization under acidic condition, especially corresponding lactone are formed, which is less active in vitro than the parent cephalosporin. So instead of presence of this glycine, which is important for oral activity, but due to this leaving group, this drug undergo this process called as solvolysis and it form the desacetyl cephalosporin lactone, and therefore it is less active in vitro than the parent cephalosporins. So it is about the SAR of cephalosporin. Next point is chemical degradation. So in case of chemical degradation, cephalosporin experience various hydrolytic degradation reaction whose specific nature depend on the individual structure. Among 7-acyl amino cephalosporonic acid derivative, the 3-acetoxy methyl group is most reactive site. In addition to its reactivity to nucleophilic displacement reaction, the acetyl oxy function of this group radially undergoes solvolysis in a strongly acidic solution to form desacetyl cephalosporin derivative. This later lactonized to form desacetyl cephalosporin lactone, which are inactive. So here same reaction is there. So due to presence of this group on third position, so it is a main group which undergo hydrolytic reaction. So here hydrolysis reaction is given. So water molecule. From water molecule, OH act as a nucleophile. It attack to this carbonyl carbon. This bond is break and minus, then this hydrogen is attached, it like NH. Then this hydrogen is removed, this bond shifted here, it become double bond, then this double bond shifted here and this leaving group is removed. So this product is called as cephalosporic acid, but it undergo this rearrangement, it form this compound called as ADCA, amino desacetyl cephalosporic acid. So it is a chemical degradation reaction. So first water molecule attack, it form the cephalosporic acid, then here there is a removal of leaving group. So here hydrogen is removed, this bond shifted here, it become double bond, this double bond shifted here, it become double bond, and this group is removed. So there is a formation of CH2, double bond CH2, it is called as ADCA, amino desacetyl cephalosporic acid. So it is about the chemical degradation of cephalosporine. Now next, last point of this topic, that is beta-lactamases resistant cephalosporine. The penicillinases resistance of cephalosporine appear to be a property of bicyclic safim ring system rather than that of acyl group. The different cephalosporine exhibit considerable variation in rates of hydrolysis by the enzyme. Thus, cephalothene and cefoxetine are the most resistant, and cephaloridine and cefazolin are least resistant. So depending upon the structure of cephalothene, there is a difference in the beta-lactamases resistance. So maximum resistance against this enzyme is cephalothene and cefoxetine. These two drugs show maximum resistance against the beta-lactamases enzyme, and cefazolin is the least or less, show less resistance against the beta-lactamases enzyme. So the same acyl functionalities that impart beta-lactamases resistance in penicillin unfortunately render cephalosporine inactive against the gram-positive bacteria. There are 100 different enzymes from various species of gram-negative bacilli have been identified. Most of this enzyme hydrolysis penicillin faster than cephalosporine. Cephalosporine containing good leaving group at position 3 is accompanied by elimination of leaving group. So due to presence of this leaving group on third position, it is important for this type of reaction. The enzymatic process occur in stepwise fashion, beginning with formation of tetrahedral transition state, which quickly collapse into acyl enzyme intermediate. This intermediate can then either undergo hydrolysis to free the enzyme, that is pathway 1, or suffer elimination of leaving group to form stable acyl enzyme with conjugated amine structure called as pathway 2. So here, if we zoom here, so here there is a structure of cephalosporine here. This one is enzyme OH. This one is called ENOH, EN for enzyme, that is beta-lactamase enzyme, which contain hydroxyl group, that is OH. So this ENOH attack to this carbonyl carbon, so like this. So if we see here, there is a, so this ENOH attack to this carbonyl carbon, so this carbonyl carbon is attacked by enzyme OH. So here, if we see here, so here there is an attachment of this enzyme OEN. So here OEN act as a nucleophile, which attack to carbonyl carbon, it become O minus like this. Then in next step, this O minus converted into double bond. This bond is break. It become N minus and hydrogen attached to this nitrogen. So here this O minus converted into double bond. This bond is break and N minus after protonation it become NH like this here. So here there is a double bond formation NH. Now it is called as acyl enzyme intermediate. This one is acyl enzyme intermediate. Now this intermediate undergo two pathway, that is pathway 1 and this one is pathway 2. So in case of pathway 1, first here the enzyme is separated. So how enzyme is separated? Here there is a hydrolysis taken place, that is water molecule added here, this bond is break, H added below and OH added above. So here there is a formation of acid and enzyme is separated, this OEN enzyme is separated. So in pathway 1, first enzyme is separated and then there is a removal of minus HX. This one is minus HX. How minus HX is removed? HX means here this is a X. So how it is removed? So here this hydrogen is removed first. This bond between hydrogen and nitrogen shifted here, it become double bond. Then this double bond shifted here, it become double bond and this X removed. So final product is like this, that is formation of double bond CH2. So again see here, first in case of pathway 1, after formation of acyl enzyme intermediate, in case of pathway 1, first enzyme is removed, here the hydrolysis taken place, enzyme is separated and there a formation of acid. Then there is a minus HX, so here H is removed here, X is removed from here. So how H removed first? The bond between H and N shifted here, then this bond shifted here and this X minus. So it formed this final product. So it is a pathway 1. So in pathway 1, first enzyme is separated and then minus HX. But in case of pathway 2, this one is pathway 2. So here opposite, first minus HX, then there is a removal of enzyme. Mechanism is same. So how minus HX? So here is a intermediate, that is acyl enzyme intermediate which follow pathway 2. So same reaction, first here hydrogen is removed, this bond shifted here, this double bond shifted here, X minus. So like this there is a removal of HX. Then after that this enzyme is separated, again hydrolysis, enzyme is separated, give the same product. So there are two pathway. In case of pathway 1, first enzyme is separated and then minus HX. But in case of pathway 2, first minus HX, then enzyme is separated. So it is a reaction of beta-lactamases, resistance of cephalosporin. So the enzymatic process occur in stepwise fashion, beginning with the formation of tetrahydral transition state, that is acyl enzyme 1, which quickly collapse into acyl enzyme intermediate. This intermediate can then either undergo hydrolysis to free the enzyme, that is pathway 1, or suffer elimination of leaving group to form stable acyl enzyme with conjugated imine structure, that is pathway 2. So it is about the beta-lactamases, resistance of cephalosporins. So it is all about the cephalosporins. So if you like the video, then subscribe the channel. Thank you. Thank you very much.